Live from New York, it's theCUBE. Covering theCUBE, New York City 2018. Brought to you by SiliconANGLE Media and its ecosystem partners.
Everyone, welcome back to theCUBE here live in New York City for CUBE NYC. This is our feature presentation and program for 2 days live coverage of CUBE NYC and also Strata Conference going on right around the corner. I'm John Furrier. Dave Vellante, our next guest, is back at Amar Anacorian, who's the Attunity CMO. Good to see you again. Thanks for coming back in.
Thank you very much. It's good to be back, guys.
It's been a year since we chatted, but a lot's changed. Obviously, in the market, we're talking about the shifts that's going on. You're seeing a revolution of the application developer market where new modern application programming techniques are being used, infrastructure as code, DevOps. But the big story, obviously, is the impact of machine learning, which is now being bundled in with AI. In the future of AI, we had discussion last night, an event here, is important. That's a huge trend. That's the catalyst.
Yeah, we're seeing that as well. It's, to your point, is a catalyst. We're seeing an acceleration with the demand from enterprise customers who are looking at ML and machine learning and AI as really what's driving the next phase in the modern data analytic initiatives. And that's kind of starts to spin the wheel. So the modern analytics are spinning the need for modern platforms, data platforms, spinning the wheel for modern data integration, which is kind of where we come in and enabling the data for all of those initiatives. So we've absolutely seen a lot of more demand. I think it's kind of a change in the phase in the market from building lakes and populating them to actually using the data. When you start using the data, you also want more real-time data. You want the data to conform to the application you're using, like machine learning and AI. And we've seen really cool innovative applications too by customers, from predictive maintenance in large automotives to fraud-related activities in financial services to improving production lines in manufacturing. So a lot of applications where data gets collected, brought, by the way, either to an on-premise or a cloud now, data lake, where the machine learning and AI runs.
So this is really your point. The machine learning and the appetite and the demand for it, the conversation, the hype, is really an indicator that the setup phase is over and we're moving to a, you know, get value out of the data. People are using it more, so that these data lakes and environments are being set up, hence the driving machine learning. Did I get that right? Is that?
Yes, I think it goes back into that. It goes into the next phase of maturity, in a sense. So I think very much like we went through a phase of learning how to build lakes. Now we're going through the phase of understanding how to build and build better processes, methods of doing machine learning, all the way from how we acquire the data to how we actually model and use it. So it kind of impacts
the So I got to ask you the question. So if people scratch their head going, okay, my data lake didn't work out. So people, it's kind of it's a test. It's like if you're not set up operational right now, you're kind of behind. Are you seeing customers who have kind of botched the data lake or didn't get it right? And what do they do? Because they want to, get to this use case that you're referring to. You seeing some folks who have botched the setup and or trying to figure out, still have not gotten there yet? Do you see any market activity there?
We've seen customers shift and pivots on the journey. So I think that as customers, we've seen customers getting on this journey for modern analytics. They got started, they knew where they were starting. They had an idea of where they want to get to. How they get there is something that many of them are figuring out on the way. So we've actually been playing with this term of architecture in motion, because we're seeing customers shift and change platforms and architectures on this path. So to your point, it's not necessarily about botching as much as
adjusting,
experimenting, adapting and adopting. And to
your point, clouds help too.
Cloud is making a huge difference.
Well, and you kind of went to the early phases of so-called big data. You said, okay, throw it into a data lake, no schema on write, a lot of unstructured data. And then it became, okay, how do we get value out of this? And then people realized, well, to get value out of it, I got to integrate it with other data sources. I got data sitting on mainframe platforms. I got data in all other databases. So it took a while for people they said, okay, it's not as expensive to just put it into a data lake. So let's keep the data instead of throwing it away. Because actually throwing it away is kind of expensive, figuring out what to throw away and what not to throw away. And then this sort of trend of, all right, how do we get more value out of it? That's where you guys come in. You've seen the results. I mean, your numbers are pretty good. You guys have upgraded your sales force, your go-to-market pretty substantially. 47% revenue growth, 86% license growth. So that seems to be working. It's a combination, is am I right, the combination of the tailwinds of the market trends, upgrading your go-to-market? Your thoughts?
Yeah, so that's a good point. It's a combination of a few things. I think the market demand, okay, is driving most of that growth. The move to the cloud and this next level phase of maturity in the data lakes requiring real-time data, requiring much higher scales. That's what we're seeing with this kind of next phase. Mm-hmm. Those things are aligned very well with the core of what our product and technology does, which in the gist of it is about moving the delta. So our technology, right, identifies only the changes in a lot of different systems, so it allows you to get only the changes, the delta. That has become much more significant because if your data lake is in the cloud and you're bringing data, sourcing data, acquiring data from a lot of different locations, you're not going to move all the data over the wire, you just want to move the delta. And about scale, it's actually an interesting story. One of our customers, very large automotive company, and they were sourcing data from today, somewhere around 500 and some data sources. And they get to month where they're moving 100 and even over 200 billion, you know, changes every month. And initially, we're excited about moving that amount of changes. But then what dawned on us is, how much would they have moved if they didn't move only the changes? So the ability to move the change actually enabled that kind of data lake. There's no way they would have been able to bring all this data economically if they brought all the data all the time into the lake. So if you want to do the machine learning, in their case, predictive maintenance, and you need to source data from a lot of places, you gotta move the delta. So first of all, the reason for the growth is that the need, because of the changes in maturity and the move to the cloud, the need for the core way of moving only the delta became significant. To that, we've increased a lot in our investment in our sales force, pre-sale, post-sale.
So that's a winning solution for you guys.
It is. And now, by the way, it's the next products aligned with it, both in our alignment with multi-cloud environments, as well as with streaming the pipeline. So from generating a stream, so we focus on enhancing the product, from generating a stream out of databases to delivering the stream to a much broader, by the way, set of environments, to refining the stream, which goes back into how do we now construct a data set that can be more easily used for analytics. So we're expanding the product line also there.
Yeah, we talked about last year, the pipeline thing. So talk about the impact of your business on the partnership side. You guys have news, hard news today.
Yes,
with Google Cloud. Talk about the news. What's the big news?
Yeah, we're very excited about it. Google has been a partner for us for a long time. And this morning we've announced that we've expanded our offering for the Google Cloud platform for GCP. And it's really focused around enabling to deliver data to a wider set of data services on the Google Cloud platform, and of course, including the data lake. So we are seeing the data lake be building around the cloud storage. So in the case of Google GCS, Google Cloud Storage, and now we've enhanced our support to deliver the data, for example, to GCS. Through GCS, you can get to BigQuery. You can get to we work with Dataproc. So again, there's a way to get a data and facilitate the building for data lake on the Google Cloud platform. So we're very excited about that. And it kind of rounds up also our multi-cloud offering. So as I mentioned earlier about companies on a journey and adapting and adopting different platforms, part of it is the hybrid environment and also became a multi-cloud environment. So we have a very roundup offering on Amazon Web Services. Again, we've done a lot of work over the past year and more on Azure and now also Google. So whichever cloud you want to build your lake on, whatever data services you want to use around it, you know, with we at Trinity now can help you get a data there.
So you guys are all in on multi-cloud for you guys.
You knocked down the big three in terms of just integration.
Yep, exactly. So again, very excited about it, and we're seeing, and by the way, this is a response not just to round up the offering because it looks nice, it's because of customer demand. It's what we're doing with Google as a partner and what we're seeing customers want to do.
So we talked earlier about sort of people shoving stuff into the data lake and then the wave of, okay, now we got to get insights out of there. Part of that has been bringing together multiple data sources, the enterprise data warehouses, which has always been a critical part of people's big data strategies. So where do you see it going now? Is this sort of, we talked last night, we had an event here talking about AI and the future of AI, and we sort of debated the same wine, new bottle, or substantive changes, and clearly the consensus was, this is something new. What do you see in terms of that AI layer coming in, and what can we expect for the next phase of this sort of data trend?
Yeah, so that's a great question. I think there's a couple of things we're seeing. First of all, there's more and more tooling, and I think we're going to start to see more applications come out, much more agility into that process. Again, we are focused on our side on the agility by allowing non-developers to make data available. because without that, the ability to scale and have data for AI is just not there. So the whole point of AI and ML is that you want more data. The more data you have, the smarter your model can become. Mm-hmm. So that means you need to scale the amount of systems and sources you feed in. And again, what we've done is part of the innovation beyond moving the delta was creating automation software that does not require developer skill set to set it up. So it allows you to scale much, much faster. Our customers are in hundreds and some of them are in thousands of data feeds today because of it. So that's part of it. The other one is real time. So starting to use AI in a more real time stream kind of way. For example, some of them can look at image processing as part of quality control on the production line. Something takes a picture and I can correlate that picture. Is everything okay on the production line? Because I have reference data for the parts that went into that specific line, which suppliers it came from, and I can do optimizations by using machine learning, either for that plant or even more globally in my supply chain. So I think the combination of scale, real time, is part of what we'll see.
So in that example, you're doing a real time comparison with the steady state and with the actual state and understanding the delta, and then what, taking action against that?
So what we're doing is feeding the data that goes into that kind of model and engine. Right? And what we're seeing is customers need more data to feed on that engine. You're seeing a plethora of, more and more libraries and from image to others to do the machine learning, to run the algorithms. They need the data from all the systems to correlate the model too. So that's where we come in.
More data, better outcomes.
Yeah. Awesome. So where are you guys going to be? Take us through your event calendar. Where can people find you out in the wild? The events coming up? You got what's on the horizon for you guys?
So there's a lot of stuff coming up. We're very very excited about our roadmap, what we're doing in the product, what we're doing with customers. Again, we're significantly investing in extending our sales force and our product offering, given the need we're seeing in the marketplace. So we're focused on this kind of idea of streaming pipeline. We're expanding, if you think about generating streams, delivering streams, and refining streams. So we're focused on continuing to expand each and every one of those. So more sources, you're going to see from Attunity growth from more sources that we can bring. More targets or places where you deliver it, from data lakes to cloud platforms. We're already in many of them, but continue to expand that because there's always new technologies coming out, down to refinement, which is where we use engines like Hive Engine to Spark Engine and others to transform the data that we've landed and turn it into analytic data sets in different environments. Again, then, because we have a more diverse data lake environment. So we're going to continue to expand that. We're have a big focus on, again, the global 2,000 customer base. We have a very unique offering for them. Mm-hmm. And we're going to continue to meet you guys and be at big industry events from, again, the big data events to cloud events and a lot of our partners because we're very aligned with them.
Well, congratulations. You guys certainly have been leveling up and being ahead of the industry and the success shows it. Congratulations. Thanks for coming on.
Great job.
Thanks for supporting theCUBE. Live here in New York City, I'm John Furrier, Dave Vellante, breaking down all the action happening in the big data, machine learning, AI, now cloud world, all coming together here in New York. We'll be right back with more after this short break.